In this session, we'll cover two types of finite state machines, Mealy and Moore. To understand the difference, we have to introduce the concept of machine output. Mealy defines its output on the transition, whereas Moore defines it inside the state. But what exactly does that mean, and what are the repercussions of choosing one over the other? Here is a simple state transition diagram of an oven. We model the oven as three independent states with transitions between these states regulated by events. When you press the bake button, the oven starts heating. When the oven exceeds the desired temperature, it transitions to idling. You get the idea. Now, is this a perfect representation of every detail of our system? No. If it were that easy, the world wouldn't need engineers to design ovens. This state transition diagram is just a first cut approximation, one that we can improve upon. One glaring flaw is that we lack any description of the behavior of the oven for each state. The oven is clearly doing something different when it's heating versus when it's idling, so let's add that information to the diagram. When you express the behavior of a system, this is referred to as the machine's outputs, or actions. Let's apply this concept within the context of Mealy and Moore machines. I'll start by adhering to Moore standards, describing our oven's behavior in incredibly crude terms within each state. Note that having defined our outputs in this manner, it doesn't really matter how we enter into any particular state. Regardless of whether the previous state was off or idling, heat will always be on during the heating state. And this makes sense given the way we've structured our state machine. Now, Dr. Moore was working at Bell Labs when he published a paper on this approach in 1956. I don't know if he was collaborating or competing with his colleague George Mealy, who published a similar paper 1 year earlier. Perhaps it was just a happy coincidence, but regardless, Mealy decided that he wanted his machine's outputs to depend not only on the state of the system, but also potentially on inputs to the system. What this means is that it can matter how you get somewhere. If I enter my kitchen by walking through the door, my reaction is going to be quite a bit different than if I were to get there by falling through my ceiling. In a state transition diagram, we implement this idea by moving the output definitions out of the states and onto the transitions. This is what the oven state machine would look like adhering to Mealy. As you can see, we don't really gain anything with this approach. It just clutters the diagram. But if we reorganize our machine slightly, the advantage of Mealy becomes more apparent. In this version, heating and idling are merged into a single state called baking. Baking has three outbound transitions, two of which are loops. When the oven now gets too hot or too cold, it exits the state, updates the output, and immediately returns to baking. This is something you can't do with a Moore machine. Now, despite their introduction early in the development of finite state machines, both Mealy and Moore remain popular today for their simplicity and clarity. Moore is probably the most constrained standard you'll encounter, with Mealy being ever so slightly more versatile. Ultimately, though, you might choose to use one over the other simply because of where you prefer to write your actions. Or, as you'll oftentimes encounter, you will find the two styles mixed together within the same diagram.